You are provoking Hindus actually. Because you get your money from somewhere, donor agency, and you build it. And then when you do that, you are not blending with the local culture. You are displaying. Your model is from Europe and Islam model is from Saudi Arabia. Suddenly morning you wake up and you see that I'm shocked, no? Because you have never seen that before. So this is the impact. We are provoking people. Actually, the BJP agenda, when you examine your own conscience, we have been provoking them, actually. Especially Protestant churches, the way they preach and so on, no? We have been preaching, they are devils, you have Satan, you go to hell. Lot of things, when you make a sincere examination of conscience, how are provoking in architecture. You won't see some place, big cathedral. The Hindu temple will be small there. Very, very small. It is like telling them, hey, look at us. We are better than you. What do you think? You have been here 2,000 years. You have been here only 20 years. Look at our structure. Look at yours. Actually, that is the message we are implying there. Even though we are not conscious of it, unconsciously, we do that. We don't blend with our culture, with the dresses, with the food, with the buildings. Everything we are alienated from in India. So we need to blend. We need to find somehow to blend with our local culture. At the same time, practice our faith. So the common areas should be protected. Don't destroy them. They're all very important. This is Vellore Fort. This is the famous fort built by Krishnadevaraya in the 15th century. And if you have come to Vellore, you can see that place. You are most welcome. You can be my guest. And I will show you what is structure like that. Lack of housing, that's very important. Because it is a challenge for human ecology. Having a home has much to do with that sense of personal dignity and the growth of family. This is a major issue of human ecology. We should make sure that every family has a home, not a house. There's a big difference between house and home. Okay, make sure that everybody has it. So public transportation, we need to go. And people should live without traffic congestion, noise pollution, and everything. Human ecology has rights. And you can demand rights. And you can tell them not to make too much of noise. And rural areas also, Pope is talking about, not only urban areas, rural areas also. There are a lot of caste problems. There's a lot of discrimination there. We need to go there and make more integral. So at last you accept your own body as a man and a female. Because at last, I am a human ecology as a man, you are a human ecology. There are so many things I don't find within me, which I'm searching, I find in you. The same way you find a lot of things you want to be strong and you want to be outrageous, or you want to be a hero, those things you are looking into the man. It's complementary, Pope says. So human ecology is interdisciplinary. We give and we take and we become one. So man and woman, we need to maintain that equilibrium. So the common good is very important. Everything is geared up to common good. I want to read one in Thomas Aquinas, the definition of common good, to give you the proper idea. This is Thomas Aquinas writing, the sum of those conditions of social life which allow social groups and their individual members relatively thorough and ready access to their own fulfillment. Okay? Overall welfare of the cosmos is our goal. Okay? And preferential option for the poor, don't leave them, because integral ecology means all the 7 billion people, I mind you, it is not 1 billion, 7 billion. That is the option for the poor. Justice between, they are coming, keep something for them, that's all. Keep something, don't exhaust everything, because there are people are coming after us. So we may leave debris, desolation, filth to future. Pope is afraid. This is what we are leaving to the future generations. He is very funny about it. So we don't give anything good, bad. So individualism should be busted. So he finishes the last quotation, 162. He writes like this: let us not only keep the poor of the future in mind, but also today's poor, whose life on this earth is brief and who cannot keep on waiting. Any questions?